Breaking news at 5, 120 people have been arrested in an operation announced today. Police say the goal was to get violent criminals off our streets. Investigators confiscated dozens of guns, drugs, and cash.
So this bust focused specifically on suspects from robberies, arsons, drug deals, even murders. NBC2 is bringing you team coverage tonight on the bust and the tool that helped in the number of arrests. We start with NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis. She's live in downtown Fort Myers, where federal agents made today's announcement.
Of those 120 arrests, several of them involve the federal court. One of them to be tried here, a convicted felon, now accused of having a gun yet again. It's things like that, prosecuting individuals at the highest level possible, that leaders tell me is one of the reasons that these operations are so successful.
But this is not a one-and-done initiative.
And it makes it far more successful when we work hand-in-hand.
From law enforcement to prosecution, united today to share the efforts of Operation Triple Beam.
United States Marshal Service is not going away.
You want to commit crimes in our county, there's one place for you, and that's behind bars in jail.
Federally and locally, the four-month operation landed 120 people in handcuffs, but more importantly, took 25 pounds of drugs off the street and dozens of guns away from accused criminals.
It was great to see us working together collaboratively, combining resources.
Behind the scenes, prosecutors worked with law enforcement early on.
Every time we work hand in hand with law enforcement from the beginning of a case, we feel so assured that the end of the case will be very successful for us.
While not their biggest bust ever, they say it's an important part of the process to making our streets safer.
We may not arrest them on some of the some more serious crimes that we would like to, but the whole idea is to take these violent offenders off the streets and utilize the whole leverage of state, local, and federal law enforcement.
Now, those arrests have occurred over the past several months. More than half of them or so have bonded out of jail. But again, the prosecutor telling me today that they are committed to prosecuting them at the state and federal level. More than a dozen of them expected to be here in federal court. Reporting live in downtown Fort Myers, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.
NBC2's Joe Petrello continues our team coverage tonight as the Fort Myers police chief explains how their technology played a large role in this operation.
We were given a packet of all the names of the people that were arrested, all 120 of them, some things that they were arrested for, like dangerous drugs, kidnapping, lewd and lascivious behavior. Fort Myers Police Chief Derek Diggs says it was technology, just like these cameras in the streets, that played a crucial part in this operation.
Utilizing data derived from our state-of-the-art real-time crime center, members of the Fort Myers Police Department Elite Special Enforcement Division and Crime Analyst Division were able to identify specific areas and persons for law enforcement to coordinate their investigative effort.
Chief Diggs went on to tell us that about 90% of the people arrested in Operation Triple Beam were from the city of Fort Myers. Everyone who spoke at this press conference says that this is just the beginning. There is more investigating to do and more people to arrest and take off our streets. I'm reporting in Fort Myers, Joe Petrello, NBC2. Break.